So this is the second in the videos reviewing the solution to quiz 3 from the spring of 2016 for ECSE 1010. Here we're looking at problem 2, which has to do with logic gates. And the logic gate that we want to take a look at is this one right here. And we can see what that is by looking at the formula sheet for the quiz. We can see it is the NOR gate shown right here. So 6 of the standard gates are found on the formula sheet, so you don't have to actually memorize anything. Okay, so what we actually want to start out with, I want to recommend one thing, and that is if you look at the OR gate, where you have A and B and Q, the A and B are the inputs, so all possible inputs are here. Okay, and in the OR gate, if either A or B is high, then the output is high. So it looks like this. Neither is high there, so that ends up being a 0. And if we go with the NOR is basically not the OR. That's what the little circle means right here. And so you don't actually have to look it up on the formula sheet if you can remember this, that the Q in this case should be just the opposite. We just negate everything, and that's what shows up over here. So you can look it up on the formula sheet, but I actually recommend that you try to remember what the OR gate does and what the AND gate does, because it just makes it easier to do simple logic combinations. Okay, so again, this is a NOR gate. And all I've really done here is to copy the truth table from the formula sheet. Okay, now that we have that, then what happens if we combine the two inputs together? If you combine the two inputs together, you're going to only have this case right here and this case right here. And you notice that when A and B are both 0, that is, they're tied together, and we call that A, then the output is high, so it looks like this. And so this configuration right here is a NOT gate, which you can actually identify by looking at the formula sheet again. All right, the next thing we want to do is to combine what we have in part A with two of what we have in part B and form this configuration right here, and then see what it is. Okay, and so here's the methodology you want to do when you start combining logic gates. It's called combinational logic. You always want to begin by taking your inputs and putting down every possibility, and it's always good to put them in the same order just because that makes it easier to follow what's going on. And then recognize what you want to find out is what's going on at the intermediate points. So I've indicated here points C and D. We're going to do those first, and then those are going to be the input to the NOR gate, which will then give us Q. All right, so this is a NOT gate, which negates everything. So if A is 0011, then C is 1100, so we've got that one. D is the negation of B, so 0101 becomes 1010, that's right here. Now we have C and D, and we have the same gate as up here. And so you'll notice that something is high here, something is high here, something is high here, nothing is high there, so it becomes 0001. And that combination for all of these inputs is an AND gate. Remember that for an AND gate, both A and B have to be high for the output to be high. If either A or B is low, and that's the case here, we've got both low here, one low here, the other one low here, then the output is low, then you get low, and that's an AND gate. Okay, so there's one more part to this question. It's found on the next page. And that is, we can add one more thing. So we've just basically taken what we had above, right there. And we've added one more configuration from part B. And we've basically put it right over here. Okay, so what we had before was the 0001, which is just above. We could fill it all out. And this negates everything, so this becomes a NAND gate. So this is a NAND gate. So it's, you can see, this is one of the things that we a point we like to make when working with logic gates is that you start out with a NOR gate, you can make a NOT gate, you can make an AND gate, and you can make a NAND gate. And it turns out if you start out with a NAND gate, you can make all the other gates too. So this is just a little exercise in playing around with logic gates, showing that we can build pretty much everything out of a NOR gate, or if we went through exactly the same thing, we'd see it's with works the same way with a NAND gate. So that's the end of question number 2, and we will move on to question number 3 in the next video.